Hello and welcome to this video.
I am Abhishek Pandya. Today I will show how to make an inverter in Magic, which is an open source tool. We can create a layout with that tool, and I will show the simplest one, which is inverter. So without wasting any time, let's get started. So first of all, open the terminal. Basically, you need to first download these tools which are there. VST tools they are known as. And I will start with the command that opens up this. So what you will do, you can see these are the layers which you can put here. Just go here in this particular window and click on G. Click on G and then you will get these grids. This is the first step you can do, where you have a finite amount of squares available, and in which you can make a whatever design you have or whatever design you want to make. So that is it. First of all, starting with this particular bars, these are file, edit, cell, window, and all things are there. You can go to the options and directly go to this tech manager. Yeah. So tech manager essentially represents the technological file that we are going to implement. Let's start with the click on this particular SCMOS. There are various technologies. What it will do, it will change the layers which were available here. So you can do this. These are other inputs, but without wasting any time, let's just go for making an inverter. So after placing G, you have got this grid. So we are going to make an inverter. So first of all, what we will do, we will make PMOS and then we will create NMOS. So PMOS ke liye kya karoge? Basically for PMOS you should have an NVEL. So we are first going to design and put an NVEL, and then we will build upon it. So as you can see, there are different trailers have appeared here. So you can go and hover around any layer and you will find out that which layer it is. For example, this is a P diffusion. This is high voltage, high volt N diffusion. This is N diffusion, so on. So we will first find what NVEL. As I mentioned, we are going to make PNP first. So this is NVEL. Click here, and see this. What appeared here is the basically errors, DRC errors. You can see here. If there are two DRC errors, because you can see here also it requires a layer, and here also it requires. So it is very simple. You can just go here and add this. Now a very basic thing, how you can create the squares, right? The squares, kaise karoge ye? So left click will put this leftmost point wherever you click it. Yeah. If you click it here, you can have a square here. Right click will decide the size of the square or this point. Okay, so left click decides this point, right click decides this point. Click here and right click here, it will change this. Right click here, it will make sure that it is lesser. Right click here, it will make it bigger, and so on. So basically that is how you can do it. So very simple, left click, right click, and you can change the size. You can change, you can make it small, you can make it point as well. Once again, this is the way to do it. Now starting with the design, basically this is the NVEL. What we will require here, basically let's create one because this is PNP transistor and this is NVEL, we have to have P diffusion. Okay, so what is P diffusion? This is P diffusion. So this is P diffusion that we have created. Okay. Now transistor that we wanted to create was PNP, and this is what we have created. Now let's make one more. So let's basically, if you want to go like this, so basically now here, this is what we want to now create, a NPN transistor. So how will you create it? What we added here, it was P diffusion. So contrary to that, we have to put here N diffusion, right? So this, okay. So now what transistors we wanted to create, two transistors we have wanted to create. Then this is what we have designed. Okay, now essential part of a transistor is gate, right? Gate we want to make gate. That is the input of the design. So we have to make sure that the size of gate is at least approximately 2 lambda. If you can see here in this tech manager, you have seen it, right? You have seen that there was 1 lambda and options were there. Okay, once again, this was there, right? Units per lambda, one lambda. So you have to at least have 2 lambda distance for making a gate. So let's say this is what we are making. So what is gate of made up of? Right? Gate is made up of polysilicon. So this is polysilicon. If you put this, what you will find? Errors, 2 errors, right? Just go here and add this. Now it should not come. Yeah. And just go here and go here. So now there are 0 errors. What we have made? This is a polysilicon gate. Yeah. So the basic thing is finished. Gate, drain, source. Okay. So this is source, gate, drain, drain, gate, source. Right. So that it is as simple as that. Now these are the layers. Okay. All the layers we have basically created. Now let's do further things. So let's click here. We want connections to the source, right? As I mentioned, this is a source. This is PNP source. So what will it make? It will So this is PNP source. So where it will be connected? It will be connected to VDD. Okay. So just go this way. Okay. This is what metal one, right? This is metal one. And what I have done is that I have put a metal one layer on this particular layer. So I will also have to create make one contact, but that will I will come to that on later on. So basically let's make it somewhat bigger, metal one. Okay, now let's connect it to sources. Okay, so same thing, same here. Now down here same thing I will repeat, right? So so metal one, once again make it somewhat large, make it the same size, right? This is fine. And this basically this is metal. Okay, so now same thing we can do here as well. So here, but from where we started, yeah, started from here, and this is 4 lambda size, and must also be 4 lambda size. So this is the basic connections for sources. Now let's connect drains, right? Drains are sorted. So same thing. Yeah, this was drain, so it is sorted, and this were sources, right? We have to put context, right? As I mentioned, we have put layers above it, so we have to somehow connect it, right? So how will we connect? So we will take 4x4 contact, right? And see, this was PNP transistor, this was N-well, this is P. So we have to have P diffusion contact. So if you see PD contact, this is what it makes sense, PD contact. So same thing, to connect these base layer to the metal layer, we have to put PD contact. This is PD contact. Yeah, now basically this was PD contact. Here it must be what? ND contact. ND contact is here. And basically N diffusion layer to contact. Same thing here. Same thing here. And this is what contacts look like. Okay. So I have put the contacts because we have put one layer above another layer. So we have to put somehow some contact so that the layers have some connections. So this is what basic thing looks like. Now we can have output from basically this was our output, right? This is drain of through transistor. Here we have so here we can do this, and this was output, right? So we can do like this. We can write out here. So just go here and write label out. You can see label out was created. So now same thing you can do here as well. This is what input, right? This was polysilicon, this was gate. So input, we can just go here and click it here. That is input of our design. Sure. Now just write, go here and once again write label input. Take a label in. Label in was created. So this is our input and this is output. We can have multiple contexts here. We can have substrate context here, if you want. But on and on, this is our design. Okay. If you want to zoom, you can press Z and it will zoom. Okay. If you want to zoom out, you can just press Shift Z. So this is what it makes. Shift Z and Z. Commands which you can use. If you want to learn more about them, you can just go to the VSD flow. Okay. So this is our design. You have zero errors, right? Yes, zero errors. You can yes. Once again, so just make labels here. Just make labels here. So label. What was that? This was VNP. So VDD must be connected there. And just go here and yeah, you can write ground here. Label ground. GND. Yeah. So that created that finishes our design. So what we have done is that we have created two transistors. So this is input, this is output, and we have contacts, and we can use multiple contacts here as well. So if you want, you can also add contacts here, right? So substrate contacts, right? This was the contact for the layers above and below, but now you can also add contact here. Okay. So this is what n substrate contact. You can just put it here. If you want more contacts, you can just go here and add one more. This created error. So what should you not do? You should go and do undo. Okay, and at least you have to put a distance somewhere, right? This will not generate an error. Okay, two contacts I have designed. You can also put two contacts if you want. So yeah, this is what opposite. The above was n substrate. Now it is p substrate. Go here and just go here. Okay, so this is how you can create contacts, and this is the design. This is what design looks like. You can still optimize this design, but for right now this is just fine. See, this is just what we have connected the different things here. You can just go here and add some more things, right? What we can do, basically you can do extract. This will extract design, and if you want to create spice model, you can do this, where the spice model creation is finished. Okay. So I will explain further things here as well, that the creation of spice model can be helpful to find out the waveforms that are generated because of this. So this was it about the basic design. So this is the design, guys. You can see this is an inverter. You can check the functionality of this inverter by using IRSIM and also using ngSpice. There are tools present in the system. So I will explain about them, both of them, in the next video. Thank you. If you have any queries or any other doubts related to this particular thing, you can ask me in the comment section. I will start a series here where I will put different designs, smaller circuits, I will make the layout of them. If you have any suggestions of which particular circuits layout I should make, please tell me in the comment sections, and I will meet you in the next one. Thank you.